with can shut down just about any opponent, and the rest of the team feeds off of that energy. He'll be a factor in this one for sure.
And things are about to get underway. We will see who comes out on top.
And you look at the future for Gregor Malvin. He's most certainly headed to the NBA. Might not be a lottery pick, but teams desire the defense he brings.
The shot by Fisher, no good.
You know, the defense to me looked like they were okay to let him prove he could make that shot.
Daniels, Blackman defending, pass to Crawford, now Malvin. Here's Daniels, the three ball. Rebound by Blackman, and with Malvin, as you said, he's a first-round talent. The offense is the only question mark.
And the offense will come eventually for Malvin. If he was a great scorer, he'd be a top three pick. But all NBA teams want a defender like him on their squad.
Blackman a screen to the wing on the left side. And Pete. The pass to Parker. Shot clock at 5. And there's a pick. MP outside. And no good. And it's Gonzaga the other way. Now Malvin. Now Booker. Outside Malvin. Let's it go from the wing. And that one goes long.
Well, MP and his team pulled off the major upset already. But they still have to take down a very talented 4-seed in their region. And no matter who it is, that kind of D isn't going to get it done.
Outside, Malvin. Daniels. Crawford inside. And once again, off the mark by Gonzaga.
I think in that situation, it was a nice try to create some space for himself with the fadeaway.
MP, right side. Inside. And the dunk by MP.
And the athleticism on full display. When MP throws one down, it only increases his confidence.
And as much as this region has been shaken up with the upset, there are still a ton of talented teams left alive.
I could see any of the four teams from this region coming out of it. I mean, they've all been tested at different times during the season and have acquitted themselves well. But after the upset, you have to think MP and this school are the favorites to survive the weekend.
Torres, that's good.
Hey, everybody's shooting the three now. I mean, everybody taking three-pointers, including Torres. Showing you how lethal he can be from back there.
Sinks the triple.
Matching baskets from the perimeter and the earmark of today's game.
Trading spray guns from long range. Trading blows from behind the arc. And after a huge upset like the one this team had in the second round, often they can relax a bit and take their foot off the pedal. If they do that, it could lead to a letdown game.
Yeah, facing a 4-seed like this is a trap game. After beating the 1-seed, you can't start playing like you've already faced your toughest test. All beating a 1-seed gets you is the bullseye being placed on your back.
Yes, count it.
Boy, he made that look easy. MP making a tough shot look simple.
Pass to Jameson. Keith. And here's Torres. Here's Mayo, guarded by Justice. Over to the left wing. Torres with the ball. 17-footer on the way. And it's Torres again missing. MP up top. Pass to Justice. Yes! And it's MP picking up the assist.
Well, how about the ball movement from MP right there? Scouts love seeing that type of unselfishness.
Jameson outside. Torres, Hawkins, Sanders defending, outside Keith, now here's Jameson from deep, Sanders pulls it in, and what we've seen from this team in the tournament, you get the feeling that MP the true barometer for how they'll play.
When he's engaged and clicking, this team looks unstoppable. But sometimes we'll see that cold stretch, and boy, as a group, they look lost. As of now, this team goes as far as MP takes them.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
And here's Torres. He has five. Jameson with it. Sanders covering. The fadeaway. And once again off the mark by Gonzaga. The Wildcats with the lead. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have. Staying aggressive and playing under control. Finding a little rhythm here that they have to like where they're at.
No surprise from my end. I mean, they've been really good, and they're looking even better at this moment.
And into the second weekend of the tournament, plenty of teams alive, and you still have a wide open field.
And as a player, I was never fortunate to make it to the second weekend, but most teams feel like they get a bit of a breather to reflect after the second round. Some teams can take big steps forward with their level of play as a result.
Torres, Hawkins, Torres outside.
Swings the ball right to him.
Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. That one on Alvin.
Watching MP play all season long. With the development he's shown, I think that he'll be a one-and-done player with this program. It makes sense with his level of skill.
When you talk about the Bulldogs, they've become the power of the West Coast.
Over the last 20 years, Gonzaga is the only West Coast team to make a title game. So incredible when you remember their humble roots.
And for a long time, Villanova's had one thing in college hoops that's pretty unique: coaching stability.
That's right. In the past half century, the Wildcats have had a total of only four coaches. That speaks to the culture of the program, and consistency typically breeds success. And the quality of the hires that Villanova's made, top shelf.
The pass to Parker. And they waste no time getting those 3 points back.
Come at us, and we'll come right back at you.
A little back and forth.
This third round matchup right now. And I gotta ask, what do you think about MP's performance halfway through?
His shot meter stayed maxed out throughout that first half. Tremendous efficiency.
Yeah, he picked and chose his spots, and when he struck, he made sure he didn't miss. I loved his approach, selective and effective.
Now here's Booker. Here's Daniels. Misses the baby hook.
And Villanova has been one of the more dominant teams of late. A couple of titles back in 2016 and 18. Hard to beat that amount of success.
The D on him has to be airtight, guys. You got to get into his airspace. And that was far from it.
Lemons outside. Pass to Daniels. Outside, Melvin. Lets the three fly. Hits it from three-point range. And as you said, Villanova always a threat to go all the way every year.
Program has done a great job of finding consistent success. Great coaching and recruiting, obviously part of it. One of the premier programs in the nation.
Now here's MP. 15 points in the game. And it's going to be two free throws. Drawing the contact on the shot.
Not call Gonzaga a mid-major. It's small in size, but large in stature in college basketball. They become a top five program and a contender for national titles.
Despite not being a so-called power conference, Gonzaga can play with anyone in the nation.
They played in two of the last five title games. No one else has done that.
about Nova's epic national title in 85. In addition to maybe being the greatest upset in Hoops history, the Wildcats' performance is also known as the perfect game.
Yeah, it's still incredible. The Cats shot almost 79% as a team. An amazing feat of game planning by the coaches and execution on the part of the players.
Now here's Lovins. Pass to Daniels. Takes the three. Here's Crawford. And three chances on that possession, but they just couldn't find a way to score. Deep MP. Good on the three-point shot.
In games like this, true MP is the real deal. He's getting any look he wants right now. Over the last few years, Gonzaga has been really producing some NBA talent. A few first-round picks, including All-Star Domantas Sabonis.
And once again, off the mark by Gonzaga.
It's just been a brutal outing for him. He still hasn't managed to make a shot, and the team is struggling because of it.
Blocked in the screen. MP got a hand on it. Outside, Melvin. Pass to Levins. He's off on that one. Excellent D there from Fisher. For this Bulldog program, this uptick in NBA talent has been incredible.
Really quite remarkable for a small school in Spokane, Washington, to produce so many guys of late. Brandon Clark, Zach Collins, Rui Hachimura, Domantas Sabonis, as Greg mentioned. Really an impressive alumni.
Charles. Fisher. Pass to MP. To the right side. The tray. And it's Justice missing.
Boy, just by his body language, you can tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
Yeah, it seems like he had great rhythm on that. You can see the disappointment in his face. And good ball movement by Melvin. Instantly giving it away once. Spots are ready to shoot.
Now here's MP, guarded by Melvin. On the wing, MP. Fisher outside for three. Drills it from outside.
Their ability, again, to stretch the floor, particularly in this second half.
Not sure if it's been by design or simply by accident, but either way, it has been impressive.
And guys getting into a nice groove here, starting to feel it.
Well, it sounded as though, or at least it looked as though it sounded like, we'll give you a three, and then we'll take it right back.
Now here's Malvin. Not a lot of room.
2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minutes.
MP with the block.
MP staying engaged, locked in on defense. That's something that pro scouts are always looking for.
And ever since halftime, they played precision basketball offensively.
There's really no comparison between the teams in terms of the way they both shot the ball since the break.
Here's Daniels. Booker. Charles defending. Crawford sets a screen. Here's Booker. And the layup falls.
That's a nice drive there. He beat the lone defender and was wide open under the hoop.
And here are the Wildcats now. MP outside. Pass to Fisher. Back to MP. Fisher outside. Six on the shot clock. MP. Fades back. It's hauled in by Booker.
And I was sure that was money on that one, but everyone is afforded an easy miss or two.
Boy, what happened on that one, Greg? I mean, that's almost an automatic shot for him.
Outside Charles. Back to MP. Pass to Justice. On the wing, MP. Charles. Here's MP, plenty of space. Another one falls for Villanova.
No hesitation whatsoever. I like when MP takes and makes these quick shots.
Here's Daniels. Back to Levins. Shoots the three. And again, Gonzaga with the triple. Now MP. From beyond the arc. Another three for Villanova.
And once they smell blood in the water, you can see the killer instinct take over.
Yeah, not taking any chances.
If you enjoyed, let me know in the comment section below. I just dropped 28 points. It's a pretty good build. Check out my other video I just released. I had a triple-double, 20 points, 10 rebounds, 11 assists. It was a very good game. Subscribe if you want to see more. Thank you very much for watching till the end. I really appreciate you. I want to make more videos of this style, sorry. And, you know, if you guys show support, I can invest in a face cam, you know, and get this shit really going for you. Alright, thank you, man. Take it easy, and see you guys in the next one.